Hey guys, so Google Gemini came out and I really wanted this to be like, look how amazing this is. But guys, this is really, really troubling. There's already cracks in this thing and it took all of 24 hours for people to start finding them, including me. But I am so frustrated at this demo and at this misleading stuff and all that kind of stuff because guys, I love Google. I'm obsessed with Google. So we're going to break this down, but let's start with a question. Here's the question. Google, what is happening? You have 200,000 of the brightest minds on the planet. Everybody's been waiting for months for Gemini. You had this code red, all hands on deck, everything else. This is going to be the ChatGPT killer. But we have to talk about Ultra because this is the thing that they put out there. This is what they put on the marquee. This is what they were demoing. Look at all this kind of stuff. They were showing it off. Guys, the problem started almost immediately. First of all, they put out this big thing about how Ultra beats GPT-4 on most of these benchmarks. But the problem was when you actually broke it down, because that sounds really impressive, right? That's what they were looking for, beat ChatGPT-4. But it was like a photo finish on so many of these things. It was like literally like a few percentage points. But this is work that OpenAI had completed like a year ago. I mean, Gemini was supposed to be competing with GPT-5. It was supposed to blow 4 out of the water, or I would hope that it was. And problem number 2, it's not even available yet. What are they doing? I get that you're dropping these things, but to drop a demo, not a live demo, but a super pre-planned demo, get to that in a second. This thing doesn't even come out until January 2024. So let's just talk about what is out now. So Bard is using Pro, which makes Bard way better, but great, right? So now it's basically kind of catching up to GPT and Claude and Pi and Bing and Perplexity and everything else. That should not get some great trophy. Yes, relative to how it was, great, but it was not good before. Okay, next, 3. All of this goes away if they just wow us with this demo, right? So I watched the demo and I was actually really impressed with it. I think I saw it like Wednesday afternoon. And here's the thing. The demo was somebody like a user was talking to this thing as quickly as I'm talking now. And this thing seems to have eyes and ears and it's reasoning and it's fast. And most importantly to me, it sounded like a friend and a co-pilot and somebody that was really doing some exciting, exciting things. And that experience was just like really cool, right? The rock, paper, scissors thing. It's like, oh, what is this guy playing right now? And even I was like, I don't know. It's like rock, paper, scissors, man. And it's like, oh, that's awesome. I also got wowed kind of like near the end when it showed like this cat jumping off a couch and Gemini's like, oh, that cat's about to jump off the couch. Oh, wait, miss it. That was unexpected. And it was sort of funny and unexpected, all that kind of stuff. It felt very human-like and very seamless and frictionless and felt like what we were all wanting out of, like that felt really different. Whoa, wow, wild capability-wise, but the experience was amazing. Well, that's where the problems start. It turned out the video was creating this misleading impression of the AI's capabilities in the first place. It showed it responding in real time to people and objects. That wasn't actually the case, because in reality, what Google was doing was it was using still image frames and these detailed text prompts, and it led to this portrayal that really diverged from the actual functionality of this AI. So for example, again, like with this, you know, the hand gesture, oh, it looks like he's playing rock, paper, scissors. It later was revealed that they actually showed like all 3 photos of rock, paper, scissors thing, and then provided a hint as to what it was actually doing and a detailed prompt. This happened over and over again. I love Andrew Main on Twitter was talking about, hey man, OpenAI already does this. Like it breaks down videos in terms of frames and then it analyzes this. So what's new about that? Well, really not that much. So let's get to what should be the really cool part, which is the reasoning part, right? And that's where Google can make all this ground back, right? So this MMLU, which is the multimodal language processing or understanding test, right? So that's this big benchmark that we talk about all the time. It's used to evaluate performance of AI models, Gemini Ultra, GPT-4, things like that. And it's supposed to measure an AI's ability to process various data types, right? Like reason and like solve complex problems and things like that. And it involves tasks that require interpreting text and solving mathematical challenges and code and images and things like that, right? So it's based on accuracy in solving these tasks, right? So Ultra, here's the thing, it outperformed GPT-4 and a human expert in this test, right? It scored 90% compared to GPT's 86% and a human's 89%, right? So that's phenomenal until we start to hear more about the comparison and how the test was run. So Ultra achieved the super high score under specific conditions. So it included access to 32 examples. And also, if you know chain of thought reasoning, it did chain of thought reasoning, which allows like a step-by-step problem solving and just makes it way, way easier for the model to do it. In contrast, GPT-4 was only given 5 examples and it didn't use chain of thought. So all of a sudden, hey, let's do this again under the same conditions. What happens? Well, Ultra's performance all of a sudden drops to 83.7, which is lower than GPT-4, which is lower than the human. Guys, that is highly misleading. Okay, does this matter? Are we nitpicking? I would say an emphatic no, because Google wasn't just trying to sell capability that was under the hood. It was selling a demo that was designed to be an experience. It was designed to sort of feel like, oh my gosh, I'm just chatting with this thing. Look at this. I'm just saying these things and it's understanding this and it feels very like human-like and all that kind of stuff. It's not even an experience you can get right now, least of all because Ultra isn't even out yet, but even when it is, you still can't do it. And it feels like Google went on vacation and put on this awesome Instagram filter that made it look like blue skies and everybody looks great when in fact it was hailing and everybody actually has bad skin. And I'm sorry, but this is really disappointing to me. And look, I want to commend the Google team. Everybody was like probably working their tail off. I think they have really smart people. I love Google. I will continue to use their products. I love this product, but I'm so just irritated and disappointed with how they're doing this with Gemini. Look, I'm sure the coding capabilities are great, all that kind of stuff, but that's going to be commoditized very soon. Anyway, sorry, but to me, this is a leadership issue. We don't see this at OpenAI or Anthropic or even Inflection. After the Bard debacle, no live demo, and now we have a misleading one at that. Google, we want to like you. Get this together. See you next time.